हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर भवदीप आहूजा। आई एम बैक दिस टाइम विद माय न्यू वीडियो ऑन मेडिको लीगल एस्पेक्ट्स एंड एथिक्स इन डेंटिस्ट्री। सो आई हैड ऑलरेडी डन अ वीडियो अबाउट वेदर वी कैन रिफ्यूज़ अ पेशेंट इफ ही रिफ्यूज टू पे द ट्रीटमेंट चार्जेस। सो दैट इज़ ऑलरेडी ऑन माई चैनल ऑन यूट्यूब। सो दिस वीडियो इज़ अ लिटल बिट इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट एथिक्स। वॉट एग्जैक्टली इज़ एथिक्स and how do we need to say apply it in our practice. So ethics is a science of ideal human character and behavior, if I go by the definition, and where the discretion has to be made between the right and the wrong. The duty must be followed and good interpersonal relations must be maintained or should be maintained. So ethics is a belief that determines people's behavior as it resides in the realm of human values, morals, individual culture, interpersonal belief and faith. So the broad principles of ethics we know are beneficence, doing only good to the patient, non-maleficence, doing no harm to the patient, informed consent, respect for integrity and patient autonomy. Let the patient decide the best choice. So as we see in the past few years, there has been a paradigm shift. There was a feeling that doctors are akin to God. It was there since time immemorial. So that shift has changed now. There has been a transition in the decision making from what is the best treatment for the patient was used decided by the doctors primarily. Even still it is done at many places, but then this has shifted from professional paternalism towards respecting the informed and autonomous decision of the patient. There was a middle road also, which we called as the shared decision making, but then it is also no longer followed. As per the current code of ethics, we are bound to follow the or respect the autonomous choice of the patient. So going by the definition again, dental ethics is a moral obligation that would encompass professional conduct and judgment imposed by the members of the dental profession or the Dental Council of India in our case. So ideally, what do we expect? The dental ethics has to be like a uniform code, if I may say so, and every dentist should wear the same one. But unfortunately, it is not the way we wish it to be, because an ethical challenge most of the freshers especially face is a poor knowledge in ethics and attitude amongst fellow dental practitioners, be it seniors, be it juniors, or be it the same age group. So we have to think of ethics as a set of principles of professional conduct, rules and responsibilities, and where we have to follow them to the hilt. So medical and dental professions, they have been are bound to provide quality and standardized services to the patient, obviously at some cost only. We are not supposed to provide them free. So in the last decade and a half, there has been a huge change in the number of clinics, courtesy the number of rising number of dental colleges in India. So we have witnessed significant rise in the number of dentists in population in India. But if we speak from a positive point of view, dentistry has still targeted only 5% of the Indian population. In spite of having so many dentists, 95% of the Indian population is still waiting to be tapped by dentists. So there is a huge potential if we talk about that. Of course, in the recent few years, the patients have become more demanding for quality care and the advancement of dental technology in terms of diagnosis and treatment, which have opened up newer vistas of treatment, where treatment planning on one side is there and a regime of ethical ambiguity and uncertainty on another, which places most of us, the dental practitioners, in a challenging situation in patient care ever than before. So we are expected to be knowledgeable and be able to analyze and attempt to resolve any ethical issues arising in patient care in day-to-day scenarios. So The only problem is we have a very limited formal training in healthcare ethics for dentists, and we just rely on our few settled, experienced seniors in the early phase of our career, and some of us happen to be at the wrong place, which does cost us big time. So the constant juggling between the right and the wrong is always, say, always has an impact on the attitude of the dentist. And it definitely results in poor or average patient care and an effect on society if we speak on the, say, broader context. So there have been many studies conducted which have, assessed ethical challenges in number of figures. So I'll be, and you will be surprised to know that the top 10 of the ethical challenges we face, barring two or three, most of them do not fall under the rule book of DCI, Dental Council of India. So ethics like moral science is self-governed. If you know the distinction between the right and the wrong correctly, then you are supposed to be following the correct. In my next video, I'll be dealing about the top 10 ethical challenges. So stay tuned. If you share it with your share this video with your friends and colleagues, do subscribe to my channel. This channel is exclusively for the dentists. Do hit the bell icon, do subscribe, and then you'll be notified of the latest videos. I'll be posting 2 to 3 videos every week for the benefit of my dental community. Thank you so much and stay tuned till the next one. Bye bye.